How to ballast your DTG3 ROV. Underwater operations require a high level of precision and stability. It is imperative that you take the time to properly ballast your DTG3 before every mission. The hollow space inside the DTG3 ensures the unit displaces slightly more water than it weighs, causing it to float. This can be balanced by adding steel plates and blocks to increase its density. You need to add plates until the density matches that of water, making the unit neutrally buoyant, meaning it will neither float nor sink. All DTG3s are tested and ballasted for freshwater at a lake close to our production facility. However, every body of water differs and the ballast will require adjustment every deployment. In order to ballast your unit, power it on and deploy it. Descend 1 to 2 meters from the surface to avoid wave motion, then take your thumbs off the joysticks. Wait a few moments for the unit's momentum to bleed off and observe the depth readout. If the depth decreases, your unit is positively buoyant and requires more weight. If the depth increases, your unit is negatively buoyant and requires less weight. Furthermore, ballast plates tune how level the unit sits in the water. Observe the roll readout. If it is off by more than 2 degrees, you may need to adjust the ballast. There are two forms of ballast on the DTG3, steel plates and small ballast blocks. The plates are used when transitioning between fresh and salt water, and the small blocks are used to fine-tune the ballast. To add plates, use the Phillips head screwdriver to remove one screw and loosen the other. Line up the screw holes with the new ballast plate and replace the screw. Next, remove the second screw and rotate the plate so the final hole lines up. Replace the screw and tighten both. Remember to keep the number of plates on each side the same. To adjust ballast blocks, unscrew the captured locking pin and pull it all the way back. Blocks can be added or removed easily. Slide the locking pin back in and tighten. It can take several attempts to get the weight perfect, but once you have found neutral buoyancy, you need to redistribute the weights evenly across the top and bottom of the ROV. This is important for pitch control. A top-heavy DTG3 will wobble along the roll axis and feel unstable to the pilot in addition to over-pitching. A bottom-heavy DTG3 feels very stable but will not pitch all the way to 90 degrees. With weights evenly distributed, the ROV will pitch to exactly 90 degrees in either direction with full deflection of the right joystick, allowing for you to travel vertically through the water column without any lateral motion. One final consideration is that ballast may need to be adjusted every time you add or remove additional components like sonar, USBL, or the grabber claw.